Well, because, I mean, there are many considerations here, but one obvious one is that we want to be able to identify drug targets that are relevant to all populations. We don't want to just find something that is relevant to European populations. And if we don't study the genetics of Alzheimer's disease in other populations, we'll never know if a particular risk gene or locus is relevant across these populations. Actually, some of the initial studies that are being done on this seem to show quite some differences, right? So when we can really integrate across these populations, we'll identify the most, I would say, high priority targets to really treat everyone. And there is also really a scientific advantage, or the discovery related advantage, is that when we compare, when we do genome-wide association studies, it's not always easy to identify which is the causal or most important variant in a given locus. Now, because of differences in how genetic variants are linked to one another across populations, we call that linkage disequilibrium differences. If we meta-analyze these data from different populations, it actually becomes more easy to prioritize what may be the causal variants, because a variant that is more likely to regulate expression of a gene that is relevant to the disease is probably more likely to come out of these analyses and be prioritized in these analyses. So it really can also help us understand better what to focus on.